Shalom and good morning to everyone. Rise and shine. Hallelujah. This is a new day. The Heavenly Father watched over you last night and watched over me, watched over all of his children throughout the world. And I pray that those that are here in the United States are awake. Hallelujah. Some of us are going to work. So we are praying for Father to bless those of you that are going to work. We're praying for Father to bless those that are coming from work. We thank Father that we're in the United States of America. Hallelujah. And that his love is poured forth upon all of us. We thank him for hearing the prayers of those that are here in America going up, hearing the prayers of those that are in Israel, hearing the prayers of his people throughout the world. So we give honor unto him this morning. Hallelujah. Not only to him, but to the Messiah and to the Holy Spirit. May Father bless each and every one of you that are with me this morning. I am going to start out this morning by blessing our Father. Hallelujah. And then I'm going to read from the Ode of Solomon. It's the Ode of Serene. But I'm going to read that 18th. I like the way that it starts out. So, Heavenly Father, we bless you. You are our eternal one. Hallelujah. The creator of heaven and earth. You created all human beings. Hallelujah. So, therefore, you put a rainbow in the heavenly so that you would remember the covenant you have with all of your creatures and creation. So we thank you for including your people, even when the rain come down. It's not just on those that are righteous, but on the unrighteous as well. You let the rain, the sun, and you let us eat food, those that know you and those that do not. So I ask your help this morning as I come to say a prayer and to be a blessing to you, Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. So Ode 18 says, my heart was raised and enriched in the love of the Most High, so that I might praise him with my name. My members were strengthened that they may not fall from his power. Infirmities, and I want you to meditate on that, infirmities, because we are going to pray for Father to heal if anybody needs healing, hallelujah, or in their bodies or in their minds, that you will hear this here. It says, infirmities fled from my body, and it stood firm for Yahuwah by his will, because his kingdom is firm. O Yahuwah, for the sake of those who are in need, do not expel your word from me, nor for the sake of their works withhold your perfection from me. Let not light be conquered by darkness, nor let truth flee from falsehood. Let your right hand set our salvation to victory, and let it receive from every region and preserve it in the sight of everyone who is besieged by evils. You are my Elohim. Falsehood and death are not in your mouth. Only perfection is your will. And vanity you knew not, because neither does it know you. And you knew not error, because neither does it know you. And ignorance appeared like dust and like the foam of the sea. And vain people thought that it was great, and they became like its form and were impoverished. But the wise understood and contemplated and were not polluted by their thoughts, because they were in the mind of the Most High and mocked those who were walking in error. Then they spoke the truth from the breath which the Most High breathed into them. Praise and great honor to his name. Hallelujah. So we ask our Heavenly Father to forgive us of any sins that we have committed against him. I ask if you have any situation going on with you. Hallelujah. We're going to pray for the infirmities first. We see that Messiah heal people of infirmities and illnesses and sicknesses. Hallelujah. Before I do that, I want to read Psalm 46. Hallelujah. So that we will keep in our mind that our Father is in us. The Word is in us. The Messiah is in us. We are covered by the blood of the Lamb. And those that might not know, if they don't know Him yet, maybe if they hear us, they will get to know Him and they will come in out of darkness into the safe, the place to be safe. Hallelujah. Under the umbrella of righteousness. I'm going to read some from Psalm 46 as well, so that we can hold fast to what Father has given us, and so that our faith will be strong. Hallelujah. So that when we say this prayer, we'll hold fast to what He's given to us. Psalm 46 says, Yahuwah is our refuge and strength. Hallelujah. You need strength? I pray that Father gives you strength this morning. Hallelujah. A very present help in trouble. Are there any troubles going on? Then in the name of Yahushua, I pray that Father send you help out of His sanctuary this morning, no matter what the situation is. Hallelujah. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed and though it be cast into the sea. Hallelujah. And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Hallelujah. We will not move. We will stand fast in our faith. And if we don't have enough faith to believe, I pray that Father will increase our faith this morning so that we will stand and believe the words that come out of our mouth from the scripture will accomplish His purpose. For Father says, wherever I send my word, I accomplish my purpose. So His word I'm reading for us so that His purpose can be accomplished in us. Then it says, verse 3, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of Yahuwah, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. Yahuwah is in the midst of you, and you shall not be moved. Hallelujah, you shall not doubt. You shall stand fast in the faith in which Father has placed in your heart this morning. Because I didn't know what time I was going to come on this morning. He just dropped the thought in me and voila, here I am. So He knew that you would be here in His presence with me this morning. So Father's in the midst of you. The heathen is raging and the kingdoms are moved. But He uttered His voice and the earth melted. So we want your situations that going on with you, with me, with our families, we want these situations to melt. We want Father to have His way. Hallelujah. Yahuwah of hosts is with us. The Elohim of Jacob is our refuge. The Elohim of Israel, He is our refuge. Come, behold the works of Yahuwah. What desolations He has made in the earth. We see that Father is wreaking havoc in some places of the world. Right now, Father is making Himself known. He's not just sitting in heaven or sitting in our heart. He's walking among us this morning, hallelujah, to show us that He is strong in us and that we are His children and He is watching over us. He makes wars to cease. Is there a war going on in your house where battle is going on in the minds of you maybe, and maybe there's something going on your husband don't understand, or you don't understand, or your kids don't understand? If Father sent His word into wars and called them to cease, you know He can work in your home life. Hallelujah. He cutteth the spear and sunder. He bringeth the chariot. Be still, He says, and know that I am Yahuwah. I am the God of Israel. I am the one they call Lord. I am the one they call Yahweh. I am the one they call Jehovah. I am that I am. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yahuwah of hosts is with us. The Elohim of Yaakov is our refuge. So now I'm going to say a prayer for if you will have anything going on in your body. Hallelujah. If there's any sickness, if I don't call it out, then you name it to the Heavenly Father and you believe that he sent me here this morning. Hallelujah. He didn't send me here for show. He sent me here so that his Holy Spirit can be a blessing to you. Hallelujah. Because I'm just an earthen vessel full up with the Holy Spirit and with the word of the living God of Israel. So Heavenly Father, I pray in the name of Yahushua that if anyone have any sickness in their body, whatever it may be, I pray, hallelujah, first of all, forgive them. Have mercy on all of us so nothing will hinder this prayer. Hallelujah, from going directly into the body and accomplishing his purpose. I ask, Father, if there's any growth in anybody's body, Father, that you would cause those growth to disappear. Hallelujah, that you would cause them to shrink into nothing. Hallelujah, and I pray that you touch any doubt in any brain, any mind, that that doubt also shrinks into oblivion and that there is no doubt and that like Psalm 46 say, that you are in the midst of them so you can accomplish your purpose through Messiah, Yahushua. Hallelujah, we thank you, Heavenly Father. Hallelujah, for hearing our prayer. If there is any doubt or question as to whether you have cancer, or they're going to diagnose you with cancer, I'm asking you to let it go, loose, just talk to Father. Hallelujah, and I pray healing for your body, for your blood cells, for your red and white blood cells to be normal. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will remove any doubt out of your brain, any doubt out of your action, any doubt when you see other people doubting, hallelujah, and they doubt whether you're going to be healed. But the word has no doubt in it. So it sends the word to you for the brain healing to your body. Hallelujah. If there's someone that have situations, maybe you've been diagnosed again with an enlarged heart or anything to do with your heart and the circulation of your blood, I pray that the Father would send his word, hallelujah, and cause your blood to circulate through your body the way that it is supposed to. And I pray, Father, that you heal backaches. Lots of people have been talking about their backaches. So I'm asking for your healing this morning, Heavenly Father, for your great name's sake. I'm asking you to touch their bones and restore their bones. Hallelujah. Give them healthy bones. I ask that anybody that is nervous or distressed or have panic attacks, I pray, Father, for you to heal those that have panic attacks. And hallelujah, that you would put a defense mechanism so that their brain will function and not allow the thought process to cause their hearts to beat fast. I'm asking you to do this for your great name's sake. Hallelujah. If there's anyone, hallelujah, that you've lost your appetite to eat, I ask that the Heavenly Father would touch your system and that he would grant in your system what is necessary. Anemic. If there is anyone that's anemic or something to do with anemic and their blood count or something isn't right, then I pray for Father, hallelujah, to cause your body to be healthy, all your cells to hear the word of our Heavenly Father, hallelujah, to know that he's already in your body and that healing is taking place in your body. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for anything else. If you have any affliction, you call it out. Hallelujah. You call it out. And you just believe, Father sent me on here so that he could tell you be healed in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. We praise his holy name. And we already know we call him different names. I don't have to repeat that. We already know there's only one Messiah, one Holy Spirit, and one God, one Elohim who created heaven, earth, and the sea. He said, I'm your physician, and he sent Messiah to show you that he is the physician that heals you, delivers you. He healed the blind eyes. I mean, he just healed that young girl had died. He brought her back to life. The young man died, the widow's only son. He brought him back to life. Hallelujah. He caused people that are crippled to stand up on their feet and be healed. So we come this morning and pray for that healing. Now you may be going through something in your mind, a mental something. I'm asking Father to give you mental abilities through the mind of Yahushua, that you will say, I have the mind of Yahushua. I'm not forgetful. I can hear. I can see. I can walk. Hallelujah. I can move my limbs. Hallelujah. For those that have maybe some problem with your mouth, your gums, toothaches, or anything like that, I pray for Father's healing for those as well. I pray that he touch your children. I pray that he touch your families. I pray that for healing of those with kids that have autism, it can be healed through prayer. So I pray for healing of that. I pray for those that have been diagnosed with contagious diseases. We pray for healing for that. Hallelujah. So we pray for you to have peace in your heart and your soul and your mind this morning. Hallelujah. We do pray for jobs for people that are looking for employment. We do pray that Father will make a way for you. You have families, and we need the God of Israel to move in our situation. So we are asking the Heavenly Father to make a way for us to be able to find employment or to get the help that we need so that we will be able to maintain our homes. And if we need legal advice, that Father, you would provide that for us. We, those that maybe need food that they don't have in their homes, we ask you to provide. We know you can tell somebody, go to that door with packages and deliver food. Hallelujah. So I bless each and every one of you this morning. Hallelujah. Oh my goodness, I recognize a name. Oh my goodness, I can't pronounce your name, but oh man, Shana. Oh my goodness, Azariah. Hallelujah, I can't believe you up this early, but then that beautiful, beautiful family that you have. Oh, good morning, everybody. Hallelujah, there's somebody else, I think Timothy Thompson. I say good morning. Hallelujah, bless your family. You have such a beautiful family. I love you. I love you, Shana. I love all of you that's on here this morning. You rejoice my heart. I love praying for you by the Spirit of Father. I know he's making a way for all of you, or you never would have come here this morning. Hallelujah. He got it, whatever you going through or not going through. He's giving you increased joy, and he is making a way for us. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, it feels very good this morning to see some names that I could call. There's another name. Oh, boy. Well, I don't know how to pronounce your name, but the middle part is Francis, because I have a friend named Francis. So good morning to all of you precious ones. I touch and agree with your prayers that you sent up to Father. Hallelujah, that he's got your family. He's taking care of your family. Some of you have teenagers, and that is not an easy thing to have teenagers, because their bodies are going through something. Their minds are going through something, and it's got the circumstances trying to get their heads and minds. So I touch and agree with everybody that got young people in their homes, that Father would cause them to hear the advice and just anoint you, Father and Mother. Hallelujah. So that you know exactly what to do and to give you wisdom. We pray for all of our veterans today, retired, those that are in military. We ask blessings upon their families, upon those women and men. Some of our women are in military. I have family in military, law enforcement, and all that. So I pray for all these people. Hallelujah. So I'm getting ready to go off. I'm going to read Psalm 23. I thank you again for being on here. Hallelujah. With me this morning. You really have given me great joy. I'm trying to get to Psalm 23. And remember Proverbs 8, Father, giving y'all plenty of wisdom. Hallelujah. So that you know exactly what to do today. Hallelujah. As soon as I hear, where's Psalm 23? And we'll be off. Thank you all again. You just rejoice my heart and my soul just to see you there. Psalm 23. Hallelujah. I'm reading from the King James. I don't see my scripture book. So then I'm going to read like it says here, which means Lord is in it. Hallelujah. It says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. His name's sake. So you know we call him Yahuwah, Yah. Hallelujah. Yahweh, Yahweh Shah. Hallelujah. Anyway, verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I want to pause a minute, and I want to ask Father to continue to bless all these husbands, hallelujah, that have taken care of their families. I pray, Father, that you increase, hallelujah, whatever these husbands need, that treasure their wives. And I pray that you bless the wives and those children, and that the husband know, hallelujah, that you have given him the best. Hallelujah. We want to thank you for the men that take care of their wives and their families and listen to their wives and love their wives. I thank you for the wives that do likewise. Husband come home fixing food. Hallelujah, just anointing all through the house. She makes up the bed. Hallelujah. She cooks his food. She blesses him. And he go out and come in blessing her. And those children are blessed. So we just thank Father. So verse 5, hallelujah. I think it's verse 5. Hallelujah. Verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. So he anointing your head for this day's journey, this weekend, and the rest of your life. Look behind you, because goodness and mercy is following you all the days of your lives. And then it says, and I will dwell in the house of Yahuwah forever. Thank you all very much. May Father bless you all when you're getting ready to get into your cars. May Father grant what you need with transportation, grant you finances if you need transportation, that he would do something supernatural for you so that you won't have to worry about your car, your tires, or your bills or anything like that. May Father bless you going out. May he bless you coming in. Hallelujah. May the light of his countenance shine upon you. Hallelujah. Show you the way to go and grant you peace. May he grant you peace. Thank you all again. Toda roba. For those of us that are preparing for the Sabbath, blessings on you. For those that are grabbing a hold of the Sabbath, blessings on you. For all of those that came on here, bless you. We just bless Father's people. We bless our Facebook friends. May Father grant what you need. Shalom, everybody. Here's a great big hug. I love y'all. Thank you. Shalom, shalom, everybody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.